Hello students, welcome to the LMS. Today I am going to discuss Fundamentals of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, Lab Subject, Unit 3, Protective Device and Wiring Circuits. The contents or topics included in this Unit 3 are various protective devices and their functions like fuse, MCB and relay, and different types of electrician tools and their functions, and describe various wiring tools, and finally state procedure of care and maintenance of wiring tools. Here the next topic is necessity of protective device. Why necessity of protective device is so important? It is used to protect equipment, machinery, components and devices in electrical and electronic circuit against any short circuit, overcurrent, earth fault, that is called protective device. Protective devices are necessary to protect electrical appliance or equipment against any type of short circuit, abnormal variations in the mains or supply voltage, overloading of any equipment, to protect operator against accidental contact with the faulty equipment, following which operator may get severe shock. And here are the some various protective devices and their functions that are commonly used in electrical and electronic circuits. First one, fuse wire or a fuse. Next, glass cartridge fuse. Next, HRC fuse, that is high rupturing capacity fuse, KitKat fuse, MCB, miniature circuit breaker, NCCB, voltage case circuit breaker, RCCB, residual current circuit breaker, ELCB, earth leakage circuit breaker, and finally relay. Discuss first one, that is fuse wire or a fuse. Fuse wire generally means fuse placed in a fuse holder, and it is a safety device which protects electrical and electronic circuit against overloads, short circuit and earth faults. As shown in the figure, many different types of fuses are used in many applications. The operation of fuse includes, it is a short length of wire designated to melt and separate in the case of excessive current. The fuse is connected in the phase of the supply. It is always connected in series with the circuit or components that need to be protected. When the current drawn by the circuit exceeds the rated current of the fuse wire melts and breaks. This disconnects the supply from the main circuit. The maximum current that fuse can carry without being burned is called the rating of the fuse wire. It is expressed in amperes or amperages. Current rating of the fuse selected for the circuit should be equal to the maximum current rating of the machinery, appliance or components connected in the circuit. Next, fuse wire and channels are made up of porcelain or bakelite material. As you know, porcelain material is ceramic material. They are used for all domestic, in houses, commercial and industrial applications like banks, offices and industries up to 100 ampere capacity. Here next one is a glass cartridge fuse. This fuse unit is in the form of cartridge. It normally manufactured in the range of 2 ampere to 100 ampere. When the fuse blows off, fuse with a carrier is replaced by new one. As it is sealed, it cannot be rewired. It is shown in the figure. Glass cartridge fuses are used to protect motors and branch circuits where higher amps or higher ratings are required, like 600 ampere, 600 volt AC is required. These fuses are used extensively in commercial, industrial and agriculture applications, as well as residential fuse panels, air conditioning, pumps, appliances and other equipments. Next one is HRC fuse. High rupturing capacity fuse unit. It is normally designed for high current. When fuse is blown off, the entire unit is to be replaced by a new one. It cannot be rewired as it is sealed one, as discussed earlier in the glass cartridge fuse. Here also we can replace new one. It is shown in the figure. A good fuse wire should be possessed following characteristics. Low conductivity of metal vapors formed when the fuse is blown off, and low resistivity and low melting point. And next is a kit cam fuse. This kind of fuse is mostly used in a domestic wiring and small usages. Another name for this type of fuse is kit cat type fuse. It is shown in the figure. We have already seen in every houses. In our houses, it is fixed near the meter board. Fuse element is located inside the carrier that is made out of the porcelain material. It is a ceramic material, and the fuse element is put on that. The main composition of this is which holds the wires. This is miniature circuit breaker. It automatically switches off electrical circuit during any abnormal condition in the electrical network, such as overload or a short circuit conditions. We have seen near the meter board, these are reversely connected. The switch is reversely connected. Whenever the high voltage or a current flows through that, definitely it will come down. You can see in your houses. It is safety device which work on the magnetothermic release principle. It is connected in the phase between the supply and load. It is manufactured in the standard rating of 6 ampere to 40 ampere. We can see it on the meter board of each and every house. When a current drawn by the load exceeds the rated value, it acts and trips the circuit, the protecting the apparatus or operator from the appliance. When current load exceeds, definitely there will be a trip in the MCB that protect the appliance or apparatus or operator from the shocks or any damage to the appliances. However, fuse may sense these conditions, but it has to be replaced through MCB, can be reset. When it glows, it goes off. After that, we can reset the MCB near the meter board. The MCB is an electromagnetic device, mechanical device. That is an electromechanical device which guards the electrical wires and electrical loads from a overcurrent, so as to avoid any kind of fire or electrical hazards. Handling of MCB is a quite safer and quickly it restores the supply. It is a very safest device, and its operating is very easy, and it protects the operator from any shocks or any damage to the appliances. When it comes to house applications, MCB is the most preferred choice for overload and short circuit protection. MCB can be reset very fast and don't have any maintenance cost. MCB works on a bimetal respective principle, which provides protection against overcurrent, overload current and solenoid circuit current. They act and open the circuit in less than 5 milliseconds. Automatic switch off under overload and short circuit conditions. No fuse to replace or rewire. It needs no repairs. Supply is restored by resetting it once again. And next one is a MCCB, molded case circuit breaker. MCCB stands for molded case circuit breaker. It is shown in the figure. It is another type of electrical protection device which is used when load current exceeds the limit of miniature circuit breaker. When load current exceeds the limit of miniature circuit breaker, that is MCB. MCCB provides protection against overload, short circuit, faults, and is also used for switching the circuits. It can be used for higher current rating and fault levels when in domestic applications. The wide current ratings and high braking capacity in MCCB find their use in industrial applications. This type of MCCB are used in industries, not in any houses. MCCB can be used for protection of capacitor bank, generator protection, and main electrical feeder distribution. Like it is used in power stations where electricity is distributed to consumers. It offers adequate protection whenever an application requires discrimination, adjustable overload setting, or earth fault protection. There are some difference between MCCB and MCB. You should know this, then only you can understand what are these. You know that MCB is a miniature circuit breaker, MCCB is a molded case circuit breaker. That is the first difference. Second difference is rated current not more than 125 ampere, and rated current for this MCCB is 1600 ampere. See the difference. 125 ampere is very less and 1600 ampere is more. It is used in the industry. Its interrupting current rating is under 10 kilo ampere. Their interrupting current ranges from around 10 kilo ampere to 85 kilo ampere. See, so much high current rating. Judging from their power capacities, MCCB is mainly used for the low braking capacity requirement, mainly in domestic applications. MCCB is mainly used for both low and high braking capacity requirements, mainly in industry. Fifth one, its trip characteristics are normally not adjustable since they basically cater to low circuits. A trip current may be fixed as well as adjustable for overload and magnetic setting. Next one is RCCB, residual current circuit breaker. It stands for residual current circuit breaker. This residual current circuit device is basically an electrical wiring device that disconnects the circuit when there is a leakage of current flow through the human body or a current is not balanced between the phase conductor. It is the safest device to detect and trip against electrical leakage currents, thus ensure protection against electric shock caused by direct contacts. There is any leakage in the circuit, from that leakage we can be protected, or a device to be protected. RCCB generally used in series with a MCB. It protects them from overcurrent and short circuit current. It is shown in the figure. Both phase and neutral wires are connected through RCCB device. These are an extremely effective form of a shock protection, widely used for protection from a leakage current of 30, 100 and 300 milliamperes. If there is a leakage current of 30, 100, 300 milliamperes, then it is used. It is essential life-saving equipment used to protect human body from electrical and is mandatory in many states for domestic installation. not in our state, but it is mandatory in other states also. In Karnataka also, they are making mandatory for using of this RCCB in domestic applications. There is a difference between RCCB and ELCB. We are going to study ELCB in the next topic. We study first and then we will discuss difference between the ELCB and MCCB. ELCB stands for Earth Liquor Circuit Breaker. This is a domestic safety device. We strip the circuit when there is a small leakage to the earth or body of the appliance. If any small leakage or to the body of the appliance or anywhere in the device, this device is used. It is shown in the figure. It is a combination of both MCB and ELCB placed in a one unit. It acts on both occasion of earth leakage and overload and protect the circuit, appliance and operator. It is shown in the figure. Thus, it protects the operator from the shocks and accidents. This is connected in series. This is connected in the circuit of appliance to be protected. Next, we are going to discuss difference between the ELCB and MCCB. We will come back again. Here, difference between RCCB and ELCB. RCCB refers to residual current circuit breaker. ELCB stands for earth leakage circuit breaker. And second difference is, it is a new name and refers to current operated device. ELCB refers to voltage operated earth leakage device. It ensures 100% detection of leakage current and is available to sense the AC as well as a DC leakage current. And ELCB, it is not preferable as it can only detect current and that flow back through the main earth wire. RCCB has no connection with the earth wire. That's why it can trip when both current, that is phase and neutral, are different and it withstands up to both currents are same. ELCB is a working based on an earth leakage current. These devices measure the voltage on the earth conductor. If this voltage was not zero, this indicated current leakage to the earth. Next, finally, we'll discuss relay. Relay is an electromagnetic switching device employed to control, that is open or close, high power circuits by means of low power input. When there is a low power input, it is operated like a high power circuits by means of low power input. It is actuated by current or voltage of the circuit to be controlled by separate source. It is normally enclosed in a glass or metal casing. It consists of one or more number of poles and contacts and performs series of switching operations. When relay contact is normally open, there is an open contact when relay is not energized. When a relay contact is normally closed, there is a closed contact when the relay is not energized. In either case, applying electric current to the contacts will change their state. Relays are generally used to switch smaller currents in control circuit, do not usually control power consuming device. Nonetheless, relays can control larger voltages and amperes by having an amplifying effect, because a small voltage applied to relay coils can result in a large voltage being switched by the contacts. Protective relays can prevent equipment damage by detecting electrical abnormalities including overcurrent, undercurrent overloads and reverse currents. In addition, relays are also widely used to switch starting coils, heating elements, toilet lights, audible alarms. And next, we'll discuss different types of electrician tools and their functions. Electrical tools are used to do the electrical work like electrical wiring installations. By using this, we can do the installation of electrical wire properly, very quickly. We must be able to choose the right equipment or tool to do the electrical work. Then only quality of our work will be improved. These are some electrical tools we have seen in the electrician bags. By using electrical tools, you can do electrical tasks effortlessly. That means without using electrical tools, we can't able to cut the wires or tighten the screws or fit any fittings. So these tools are used without having any effort. Although necessary basic tools vary by job, most tool makers contributing information for this report said many electricians have basic set of tools that includes pliers of various types, wires, cutters, stripers, crimpers, multi-bit screw, nuts, nut drivers, utility knife, a tape measure, a level and hex keys. Level means a leveler. On the job, some tools are hung on the belt while others are sorted and carried in the tool bag. Often one of the many new soft-sided designs. Electricians also usually have basic testing instruments including multimeter, a voltage tester, a clamp meter, and a fork tester to measure the current and voltage. We're going to discuss one by one as shown in the figures. A tape measure is essential for measuring heights for the switch and outlet placement, centering, lighting fixtures, and so much more. Without using tape measure, we can't fix any electrical switchboards or switches or plugs. Using these measures, we can fit in the proper places. Here is a multimeter. It is used for measuring a current, voltage, and power, and resistance, and temperature, and many more can be tested using this multimeter. Mainly it is used for measurement of current and voltage and resistance in an electrical circuit. That is shown in the figure. Wire striper. A good quality wire striper will do a clean job every time and is designed with a cut-off portion and various size cutting teeth for different sized wires or cable. That is shown in the figure. You can use a wire striper to cut the wires or to remove the skin of the wire. Next is a fish tape, also known as a draw wire or a tape. Fish tape is used by electrician to route a new wiring through walls, metals or electrical and PVC conduit. Non-contact voltage detector, a quick safety check to see if there is a current present or a circuit is near to indeed alive, means current is there or not, can be seen without contacting any plug or switchboard. That is a automatic voltage detector has a on-off switch. Next, flyer. Flyers are specially designed for wire cutting. Their cutting edge goes to tip of the flyers and comes in handy to trim wires in tight spaces. Flyer is shown in the figure. You know, in houses, these are always be with you for making wire tight and crimping the wire for the purposes it is used.
Level.
It provides accurate readings including horizontal, vertical and 45 degree angles. These levelers are used for the correct fitting of these electrical switches or plugs on the walls. Flashlight. When lighting conditions on the job sites are not the best, a good flashlight or a work light can save the day. Flashlights are used because electrician needs light when fitting a fixtures to the wall. That makes him easy to fit a fitment on the wall. Wire crimper. A crimp tool is one of the best ways to repair wires causing a faulty circuit connections. Investing in a good quality crimp tool ensures a long lasting seal and will give a decades of reliable use. This wire crimper mainly used in the telephone internet wire connections, and it is more useful in electrical connections also. Screwdrivers. A screwdriver is a tool manual or powered for screwing and unscrewing the screws that is shown in the figure. A typical simple screwdriver has a handle, a sharp ending tip the user puts into the screw head before turning the handle. A typical simple screwdriver has a handle and a sharp ending and tip the user puts into the screw head before turning the handle. Electrical tester. An electrical tester can measure a variety of electrical parameters from current and voltage to resistance, continuity and beyond. An electrical tester is used by electrical contractors to assess everything from live wires and circuit breakers to electrical panels and power transformers. Wrench. Wrenches are used to tighten the hex head screws, which are sometimes found on ceiling fans, light fixtures and appliances. It's a good idea to own both metric and a standard set of wrenches. Not only one used, many wrenches are used in a electrical wiring system. Needle nose pliers. Another essential special electrical tool is a pair of needle nose pliers, also called as a long nose pliers, used for bending and twisting wires. Whenever you're making a screw terminal connection, the long narrow tip makes this great tool for detailed work. Most needle nose pliers also including cutting jaws for trimming wires. Next, hammer. Hammer is a tool consisting of weighted head fixed to the long handle and swung to deliver an impact to a small area of the object. This can be, for example, to drive nails into the wood, to shape a metal as with a forge, or to crush the rock. Hacksaw frame. Most hacksaws are hand saws with a C-shaped working frame that holds a blade under tension. Such a hacksaws have a handle, usually piston grip with the pins for attaching narrow disposable blade. The frame may also adjustable to accommodate blades for different sizes. Care and maintenance of wiring tools. This is an important discussion in the wiring system. Taking a proper care of tools will help you perform your job more efficiently. Tools are properly stored in the organized fashion rather than being tossed into a bag or a box that is done on the wall surface. Each wrench has its own cradle or a post slot, and wrenches are arranged by size. They even face same direction. Sockets are snapped into socket trees or arranged in the socket trays. They are sorted by the size. We have one set of socket, and another for metric. They aren't be mixed. They can't be mixed. Screw doors neatly arranged. No one has a chipped blade or a dirty handle. Torx screwdrivers and Torx wrenches are set to zero, not left on the last setting used. There is not a single spot of grease or a dirt on any tool. You should maintain that. Always wipe each one of the before putting it away. You have to clean it before putting it to the their place. Bits inspected. Damaged bits removed for replacement. Good bits put back into the correct storage slots of the container. Battery removed and put back in its storage slot. The tool set is designed in that way. Tool and accessories goes into the case they came in. That case was designed to be used to make that tool set to and from the job. Turn meters off and set the measurement function to safest position. Example, highest AC voltage on the digital multimeter rather than the last setting used. Turn off the meters because it saves the battery. Test equipment care is also an important thing. When done using a tester, remove the leads. Next is, we come to multiple choice questions. We're going to discuss multiple choice questions, that is MCQs, one by one. Multiple choice questions. Here, first one is a protective device used to protect equipment against, as you earlier discussed. Out of four, only one answer is correct answer. You can see the options: short circuit, over voltage, earth fault, all of the above. See, we have discussed all three: short circuit, over current, or over voltage, earth fault. Because of this, the protective device used to protect equipment against all these. So all of above is a correct answer. The fuse rating is expressed in terms of current, voltage, VR, KVA. Which is correct? Fuse rating is expressed in terms of current, that is amperes. Amperes is a correct answer. Therefore, first one is a correct. Fuse have got advantages of current limiting effect under short circuit conditions, cheapest type of protection, inverse time current characteristics, no maintenance. I think all of the above are correct, as we discussed in the topic. Fourth one, on which of the following effects of electric current a fuse operates? Photoelectric effect, electrostatic effect, heating effect, magnetic effect. We have seen fuse is melted when over current or over voltage flows. The answer is C, that is a heating effect. Fuse performs only detection, only interruption, both A and B, none of the above. Both A and B is a best answer. It detects and interrupts. A fuse element should have best melting point. Which one is correct? High, low, same, medium. I think low. Fuse element should have low melting point. HRC stands for, we discussed, high rupturing capacity fuse. Check all the answers. This is a bit confusing. High rating capacity, high rating coil, high rupturing capacity. So answer C is correct. Check the live wire as is used. Tester, screwdriver, wire stripper, none of them. Tester is used, obviously. A is correct. Handy tool to strip or cut off the insulation on wires, fish tape, level, electrical tester, wire stripper. Answer is D. What should you do with a multimeter after completion of a job? Meter should be on position. Set the measurement function to safest position. Turn meters off both B and C. Answer B and C. You cannot put on the meters on. B and C are the correct answers. These are the some references you can refer and click on the material provided. Click on the link, what the material you get it from.